Okay, I checked the boat out for its first maiden voyage about a week ago, and it did not go well. One of the problems was I picked a day that was just way too windy. Even though I went to a nice little inland lake, it was at the boat launch, it was wavy, really, really difficult. But despite that, I learned a lot and I made a lot of corrections to it for its next launch. And one of the things that happened with it is the trailer was too high. So I had to end up pulling the entire boat off the trailer, lowering the trailer down about 4 inches, and then putting the boat back on. And that's where this boat, I think I really like it, is because to lessen the weight, obviously I took the motor off of it, I took the pontoons off it, I took the trolling motor off it, took the battery out of it, lightened it up probably 150 pounds at least or more. So it made it a little bit more manageable to do. It was still heavy, but it was more manageable. So I ended up doing that, lowering the trailer, and that worked out really well. I also found that when I was there and I was trying to attach it to the dock, one of the problems I had was obviously I did not have any boat cleats right here, which this isn't mandatory. I could have beached it. Now, obviously, what if you don't have a dock? But I ended up getting some boat cleats. Got one there. Got one sitting right here. And I got two more on the other side of the exact same spot over there and then over there. So that makes it tying to the dock much easier because I had a huge problem with that. I was basically connecting my rope to the nose ring. That's what I call it, to the ring that's at the front of the boat. That was not a good plan. The other thing that I noticed is when I put the boat into the water, I looked and there was probably about 3/4 to a full gallon of water in the boat. Now, this boat was completely dry when I took it out, and all of a sudden there's a gallon of water sitting in it, and I just put it in the water. So that's concerned me. I thought, where am I leaking? But I thought, well, maybe it's because when I did it, what I did is I backed the trailer down the ramp and I let the boat be loose, and it just kind of swashed off into the water, okay? Which is kind of common how you single boat launch. And I think what happened is the waves, I think it came off the trailer because the trailer was too high. So it came off very unevenly. And I think some water just splashed into the boat. That's kind of what I theorized. However, I wanted to, ensure that in case I do get water in this boat, I'm going to have a bailout. So one of the things that I have installed is right here. You can see it. That's a little submersible bilge pump that I've got, and then I have it wired right here to this cord, goes through this pipeline right here, and to the battery, which is in the front of the boat. For weight distribution, I kept the battery in the front of the boat because the motor is on the back. So anyway, that's my little bilge pump. That works beautifully. Pumps 1,100 gallons a minute. Really is pretty inexpensive. The other thing that I found out about that I didn't know about, so I'm gonna move this over, is this gas can or this gas tank right here is brand new. It's a plastic one. It does not have a vent to it. And I didn't know anything about this, but obviously what happens is if it gets hot or if the fuel shakes around in it or whatever, it will create pressure. And if you have it just set to your motor like I do here, I have this line coming here, and then it's connected to my motor right there, it will flood the carburetor motor out because it will be constantly pressurized and it will flood the motor out. What you need to do is just put one of these little inline check valves right here in it, and that solves the problem and solved the problem for me. So I just want to share that with anyone who doesn't know. Other than that, this works out perfectly. So the gas tank, gas line, all that works good. Motor works good. The bilge pump comes out this hose right here at the end. Now I think this is a little kind of hacky right now. I'm gonna do something better with it. I just don't really have a good idea for it yet. So I thought, well, at least that solves the problem. I mean, granted, it's probably never gonna run because when I took this boat out the second time, which I have another video on, it didn't have any water in it at all. It was fine. But that's a precaution. This thing takes on water. I at least got something to that's gonna be dumping the water out. Come over here, and the other thing that I did is I mounted my transom, or not my transom, I'm sorry, my transducer for my fish finder right there. And it goes up this tube, the cable does, comes in there, and then basically it coils up and it's right here. Now, the fish finder I have is a Garmin Striker 4, and it's all one portable unit. So you just plug that in, it has its own battery and everything, and it can like sit right on this deck or whatever. It works out really well. I haven't officially tested that with the boat yet, but I'm sure it would be fine. And then of course I added a fire extinguisher right there. Okay, again, that's a little bit of a hack the way I have it mounted, but for now, just the way I'm gonna leave it. The other thing I did is I added this little transom saver right here. Okay, so this mounts down. If you see, it mounts to the axle of the trailer, comes up, and it rides the engine like this. So basically it takes the weight of the motor and puts it on the axle to take some of the weight off of the transom. Now, this isn't a very heavy motor. This is only, you know, 7.5 horsepower motor, 75 pounds. It's not really all that heavy, but and this transom could hold it no matter what. But one of the things that Honda says, as they say, do not transport this thing tilted, locked into one of its tilt positions, okay? Because it could slip out, it could, you know, have problems. It's not good for it. Plus, it puts away a transom. So I got this transom saver right here, and I got the box here. I'm going to put it on the boat. I'll just film it right here. It's the Panther transom saver, the 28-inch to 59-inch. This thing was beautiful, okay? Very easy to install, very adjustable. So I got the motor propped up. The other problem is when I lowered my trailer down about 4 inches, the very bottom of this motor right down here, that was only like 6 inches off the ground. I think now it's about 15 inches off the ground with this this transom saver on there. So it keeps the motor, you know, it's locked in place. Little bungee cord here just keeps it strapped. Everything's tight. Again, I transported it to the lake today, and it worked flawlessly. It was excellent. Very easy to take apart. You just undo this bungee cord right here, lift the motor up so it locks in its upper position, and then you just twist it out. Comes right out. Really simple. So highly recommend that for at least smaller boats and where you have the axle that's further back, because you can see my axle's a good probably 2 feet back from where the edge of the boat is. All right, so I needed to have something that would work like that, and this worked out perfect.